Welcome, hello to you, hello to everyone here.
Okay, so, yes, please.
No, I say my pleasure to be here. I heard the interesting conversation. So I have two comments for the conversation before. One, since Revivo, we don't have any football player that can play at the level of Turkish, unfortunately. And two, regarding partnership, I can tell you that as a CEO of an AI company, what we're missing the most is engineers. And if we can start with cooperating on resources, tomorrow morning, I'm able to interview Turkish engineer and to join them into our company. No problem with it at all. So I think that it can start with the basic, with actually employees, and then after that also with companies. So this was my 5 cents for the previous conversation.
Yeah, and I can see that you're also interested in football. That may also be a common issue between us. And you'll be talking about the financial impact of scaling your data monitoring. And that's a great issue now. In Turkey, we work a lot, but the financial results are sometimes problematic. And recently, we're talking a lot, especially here at TRI, and also there is a sister company, Digitopia. We're talking about key objectives and results, and that may turn into financial results more easily. So I leave the stage to you. Do you have a presentation?
Yes, I have a presentation. I can share it, or I can talk freely.
But you choose. If you want to share it, you have to share
okay.
Your screen.
Yeah. Yeah, I will share my presentation, no problem.
Okay.
Second.
Oh, it's like my screen. How many tabs are
there? 1 second. All yeah. Right. So you see my presentation?
Yeah, but you have to make it full screen.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
All right.
So the stage is yours. Take your time. You have 20 minutes.
20 minutes. Okay, I'm counting. Okay, so hi, everyone. So again, my name is David Ray. A bit background about myself, very quick, to make this discussion very effective. So I'm the CEO, co-founder of Anodot. Before that, I was a co-founder of a company that sold to Akamai, totally different space in CDN. Then I was CTO in Akamai itself. And then I was also CTO of a company that is the parallel to Uber and Lyft in the US called Getty, of bringing taxi with mobile app. Actually, from that period of time that I was their CTO, I experienced a lot of issues in data analytics mainly. And this is exactly where Anodot is targeting, and this is the problem that I wanted to solve. I will say that together with me, I met at that time Dr. Ira Cohen, who was chief data scientist in HP. His expertise is around machine learning, forecasting, anomaly detection, and anything that is intelligent on top of the data. A little bit about the company. We raised money from Intel Capital, SoftBank, Tier 1 investors. We were many times nominated as leading a new AI category for data analytics. We have offices all over the world, hundreds of customers for that. So what actually I would like to talk about is that what I'm seeing in the market. I'm seeing in the market, and we have many customers that I can testify that are collecting a lot of data. And today, the data collection is a problem that is solved. I'm saying solved, meaning that, you know, there is a lot of places where this market can grow, but the challenge itself of collecting data is a challenge that is solved. You can see huge success of companies like Snowflake, $98 billion MarketCap. You can see Google, BigQuery, with thousands and thousands of companies that are moving to the cloud. And I will say that personally, I see many companies that are shifting from on-prem solution like Vertica, like Hadoop, and are shifting all their data into cloud data. And why is that? In order to have a more stability, less maintenance, and more clean data for their business. Where the main goal, it's very important, and you talk about OKRs, objective key results. I will say that the main goal is to get from the data much more from your business than you will do it without the data. And you see today that many vertical, if you take gaming companies, if you take fintech, financial, telco companies, all of them are becoming actually more and more data-driven businesses. It's all about how you take your data and you create a competitive edge and efficiency from the data itself, understanding what is happening there in your business and how to make it more effective for your business. And I will talk about that for a while. But what you see today, although that many companies are collecting huge amount of data, investing millions of dollars around normalizing the data, either from data pipe, like Kafka or Kinesis or other tools, or through a data lake, like Databricks, Snowflake, BigQuery, Redshift, whatever, S3, you will see that still most of the companies are suffering from lack of insight or too late insight from their business data. And you see a lot of article around business glitch, price glitch, ineffectiveness of the business. And you ask yourself why, how come? Because although you are collecting so much data and you know almost everything around the data, still you are experiencing so much gap and so much latency in the insight. And the main reason is that you will see that most of the companies are still beyond in terms of data analytics. Most of them are trying to understand the big data with a way that doesn't scale. When I say way that doesn't scale, they try to understand the big data with visualization, with dashboards, a lot of dashboards. I can see a lot of companies that are putting more dashboards and then they want to track another thing. Let's put another dashboard and so on and so forth. Or on top of that, building all kinds of internal tools with all kinds of static threshold and condition and rules, naive rules to understand that if something is crossing a certain threshold, then they will know about it immediately. But those solutions do not scale. And this is a big problem that Anecdote actually is trying to solve. My apology, I need to connect to my charger. You notice that I'm lacking of juice. And you see that this problem is actually a problem that is not solved. So what Anecdote, what we are doing actually, we are leading a new market that is called in Gartner, in analysts, it is called augmented analytics. Or in other words, how to take the data to analyze it in another way than human being, but to use AI techniques from anomaly detection, forecasting, correlation, in order to understand and answer three main questions that are interesting for any business. what is happening, why it's happening, and where it's happening. Those three questions are essential for any business. And in order to get the most from your data, in order to provide more effectiveness from your business, you need to answer these three questions as fast as possible. And we move for an approach that says, you don't need to go and in pull mode, check your data all the time because it doesn't scale. You need to get the insight in push. You need to get the insight in alerts and stories about what is happening, why and where. On top of that, we also added another capabilities that says what will happen. What will happen tomorrow? What will happen next month? And so on. So what we have developed is an autonomous business platform with dozens of patents around it, with a team of 10 data scientists that are able to learn the data in real time. We developed ML algorithm, machine learning algorithm, in the streaming of the data in order to be in real time. And we understand the normal behavior of the data. We are able to connect to any kind of data source. It can be your Google Analytics, it can be your BigQuery, Google AdWords, whatever. And then we are streaming all the data and understanding the normal behavior of the data. We are correlating that in order to understand and give you the answer for the where and the why. And then we are getting the conclusion that we are sending to the end user. Let me give you a few examples from real market. We have customers like e-commerce, for example, that they have dozens of products that are selling all over the world. Take, for example, Zara, okay? And now there is a drop in selling specifically in London, for example. Now, when you have thousands and tens of thousands of products and you're selling them all over the world, and now you need to understand in every weekend, in every holidays, what is the normal behavior? And now you want to see and check that in this specific day, there is no any drop in your business. It's very difficult, almost impossible to do it with your eyes and manually. So what we are doing, we are learning all the combination there. We are learning all the products behavior in all the countries for all the operating system. It can be buying from mobile devices, it can be buying from desktop and so on. And we will let you know what is happening and if there is a drop in sales in one or two or several countries or several products. And then we will correlate it to tell you the whole story. And the story can be something internal. For example, you deploy a new version, a mobile app, that now the purchase in a specific region doesn't work and people cannot buy the product. Or it can be something totally external, like your competitor now put a campaign and reduce the price for shoes selling, and now you are selling less than that. You probably have heard and seen the Facebook downtime. I can tell you that we checked all our customers during the downtime. Sometimes the insight can be negative, meaning that you are losing revenues. And sometimes that can be positive that you are getting revenues. Specifically in Facebook, what we have seen is that some customers that were relying on Facebook from advertisement point of view immediately saw a drop in the revenue using Anodot. And then immediately shift all automatically, by the way, shift all the budget into other ad networks. And other ad networks that are working with us, we have seen a huge spike in revenues because or thanks to this specific incident. Now, once we provide the insight, and the insight can be sent to all kind of channels, it can be to the your Slack, to your email, to whatever, then there is a kind of feedback mechanism. And the feedback mechanism is very important, because you want to know exactly that what you are providing to the end user is very accurate. And this is a very important part, that now we can measure the impact of every insight. So now what you can do with the machine learning and with the mechanism, you can calculate how much revenue you save for every company and the total aggregated revenues over the time that you saved because you detected things very, very early in the time. And what AI actually brought here? AI brought a very important thing. This is what we call the time to detection. With AI, you can detect much faster, 80% faster in average with our product, specifically with our product. And then if you accumulate this over the year, we are talking about millions of dollars there that we are saving for telco companies, for fintech companies, gaming companies, and so on. Should I leave place for questions, or I continue to speak freely?
Well, actually, I'm the one to ask questions, because we don't get questions from outside. And I'm very interested in what you're explaining. So please go on a little more, and then I may want to ask one question.
Excellent. Okay. So this is an example of a customer. What I want to show here, what is important for me to show here, is the concept of preventive maintenance, preventive detection. The idea to detect very, very soon in the time, by understanding that normal behavior, by understanding that now it's supposed to be another value in your revenues, and you are getting a different value, and you need to know about it now, and you need to act now. And this differentiation is the money. This time of time to detection is the money that you are getting as ROI for using the AI on top of the analytics part. This is a little bit about some of the customers or the companies that we are working with. And again, I will tell you that all those companies, or most of them, have a data lake that is very stable. I will say around 30% using Snowflake, another 30% maybe S3, and another 30% all kinds of other solutions. Many of them, or most of them, have positions of data engineering, data ops, and then they change the whole culture of their company to be data-driven and AI-driven. And only then, only when you are changing the whole culture of your company, then you are starting to see the fruits of this effort that is a big effort. Right? But only then, only when you are very stable in your data, you put the right tools on top, and only then you can start to measure the result of those objectives that we should not forget is to make your business more effective. And we are not collecting data just for collecting the data.
Okay, now here comes the question. There's one issue here we face when we talk to the retailers mostly. During the pandemic, they put all their power on their online channels, and they built their omnichannel and everything else. And they found out that the marketplaces were good outlets for them. And afterwards, they found that the marketplaces actually had the customers for themselves, and they were not really tied to the customer. So now everybody's trying to build their own marketplace. So how do you approach this problem? I guess this will not work, and some system like yours mobilizing the brands between different marketplaces will work better, I believe.
So I will tell you something around retail that I've seen in the recent years. So if you're talking about retail, pure retail, that is not e-commerce, then what I see mainly in the usually in the market, that the retail are still not very mature in collecting data. I see that, for example, the data is getting very, very late in the time. Sometimes you get all kinds of report, Excel, once a week or once a few days. And if there is an intentionality to move to a very data-driven business, there is a need for a change in terms of culture of how to collect the data. Sometimes it's very difficult. It's not easy. Because if you have, let's say, warehouse, okay, that is very, I will say, you don't have IoTs, or you don't have all kinds of devices that are able to connect, let's say, the SKUs, or collecting what you have there. And you cannot, it's very difficult to track, for example, if you are moving now a shipment from A to B, how do you track that? This is a very difficult challenge. And this is where I will say that, first of all, this has to be solved before thinking about any kind of AI. You need to think how you are collecting accurate data. You need to maybe check with all kind of startups or companies that can deliver you the information or the data that you need in order to have this very robust visibility, and only then moving to the next phase of saying, okay, now I'm very well equipped with the data. Now I can get very smart insight, because you don't know what you don't know. And this is the main problem. And when you don't know what you don't know, you cannot act, or you think that you know something, but you only think, okay? Because you only see the tip of the iceberg, you don't see all the details. And I can tell you, I saw so many times companies that took the wrong decision because they thought that they know what they know. And this happened a lot in life. We know that we think that we know something in every a domain, every aspect, even with people, you think that you know something after you meet him. Many, many times, suddenly you see something different. And this is the same here, okay? If you don't collect the right and accurate information, it's very difficult to go to the next step. In e-commerce, it's easier. In e-commerce, because you are going to online shoppers, you can actually connect to the cloud, connect to the AWS, Azure, whatever, and you have all the tools there in order to provide you the whole visibility around it.
Okay, so I guess this is a good interaction for the next speaker, because the next speech is about AI role in our company. So let's get to the structural part of that. I thank you very much for your speech.
Thank you.
And bye.
Bye-bye.